So what's inspired the special issue? As you know, the journal is focusing on plant sciences, but today we cannot investigate the biology and physiology of plants without taking into account the microbes, because the plants are not living alone. They are living with a cortege of microorganisms. So we aim to get a better understanding of the role of the microbes and microbiome on plants by inviting a lot of the best experts in the field to talk about their work on the microbiome of plants. I'm very interested on understanding how microbes can help plants to support the climate change, to cope with drought stress, cope with global changes, warming, and so on. What is the future of the microbiome research, or at least the research investigating the interactions between the plants and the microbiome? I think that for too many years, we have been just making a list of microbes living in plants, trying to make a census of the microbes interacting with plants. So now we have a broad picture of who are there, when they are interacting with the plants, but we don't know really how they work, what are the mechanisms taking place during these interactions between microbes and plants. So the future will be to get a better understanding of the mechanisms, the fine-tuning of the interactions between plants and microbes. And this means that we have to develop new tools like transcriptomics or metatranscriptomics to know what are the functions expressed by the microbes living in plants or living on the plants or living around the plants. Hopefully we may in the future, by running that kind of experiments, find microbes which may help the plant to sustain stresses such as drought stress. Ideally, we may find a cortege of microorganisms, fungi and bacteria, that we can inoculate to the plants to help them to support drought stress. That's one of the focus of a few papers in this special issue. We need to walk along the continuum between genes to ecosystems. And in this special issue, we have been lucky enough to have these experts able to talk about genes, genomes, but also microbial ecology and the impact of global change, not only climate change, but also global change on the plant communities and the microbial communities. The major take-home message for the readers of that special issue would be a microbe will save the world. And of course, to go to the woods and the mountains to look at the microbiome there.